إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وعظيمنا وقائدنا محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم أن نلقاه. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، يقول تعالى في محكم التنزيل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. My respected brothers and sisters, one of the concepts in the Quran came to mind and I did some research about it. I want to share with you what I found about one of the relationship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly mentioned in the Quran in many different types and shapes, and that's the friendship itself. And in English we have the word, the friend means somebody close to you, somebody you talk to. However, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since the friendship is extremely important in the relation or in the life of the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran, and even He shows the type of friendship in the Quran. And He mentioned many of them. If the time allows, we'll share with you about 7 or 8 or up to 10 of these type of friendship. Since Allah mentioned it in the Quran, it's worth it as Muslims to understand it, to study it, and to apply it in our lives based on the teaching of the Quran and how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam translate the meaning of all these words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And the Prophet, he says in one of the hadith, المرء على دين خليله، المرء على دين خليله، فلينظر أحدكم من يخالل. In fact, if you think about the friendship, you'll find someone you like to the point you share all of your happiness and sadness with. And we call him خليل. خليل means somebody attached to you, and that's mentioned in the Quran, a type of friendship. فلينظر أحدكم, you have to search and seek the right person that will guide you to be in a good shape in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So definitely very important to evaluate every single person you have relationship with. If you find somebody you trust to the point you're willing to have the same faith that like that person, المرء على دين خليل, even the faith and the religion you carry in your heart should match or perfectly match with the person who's close to you to the point he is your friend, and a friendship we call it type of khalil. So how the Quran mentioned this word in the Quran, let me just share with you some of them, and I hope after the khutbah, when you read the Quran, every single word you see from the one I mentioned, pay attention to it. Because as I mentioned before, Al-Quran is not just words to read. Al-Quran is not a book to have knowledge about. Al-Quran is not a book you read when there is a calamity or a problem. Al-Quran is a way of life. Means I want to live the Quran, not to carry the Quran. I want to live my life as the Quran wants me to be, not just to read the Quran when there is occasion for it. We have a lecture, let's start with the Quran. Somebody died, let's read the Quran. We have a gathering, let's read the Quran. Somebody want to get married, let's open it with the Quran. The Quran is not only for that. The Quran is a way of life. Should reflect in your life. Means you behave as the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be. The first type of relationship, Allah mentioned it in the Quran, we call it Al-Qareen. Al-Qareen. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينَ. Qareen is somebody who's attached to you and always take you away from Islam. Qareen is someone, we call it Qareen من قرن, means attached to the person, and somebody have a constant relationship all the time with, and kind of a friend that always with you. And you know, sometimes when you have a friend and you like to be with groups of friends, could be relatives, so you want to be with them, so you want to adopt their methodology of life. And that's something you have to pay attention to. And for those who choose to be together, away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and put Allah in their back, means enjoy their night by doing whatever they want to, enjoying their day by having fun and entertainment without paying attention to what Allah asked them to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, anyone like that, Allah will assign, will appoint a devil, a shaitan, فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِيمٌ. And that shaitan will guide him to hellfire if he chooses to away to be away from Islam and the teaching of Islam. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَصُدُّونَ عَنِ السَّبِيلِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. And in fact, when you have this type of relationship with somebody, you think you are doing the right thing because you're happy. But Allah says, وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. But they think they are in the right path, but they are not. So this is one type of relationship. We have to pay attention when we think about Al-Qareen, Quran al-Su, and always we use this word with the bad influence, not with the good influence. Ya'shu means another. Even Allah says in the Quran, Ya'shu, وَمَن يَعْشُو, a word worth to think about it. Ya'shu. There is one famous scholar in the history of Islam called Al-A'sha. And the reason why they call him Al-A'sha because he cannot see clearly. And Ya'shu means he can't see, but he cannot tell what he's looking at. Is that a man or a woman? Is that a picture or something else? Means you have a hard time to tell what you see. Allah used this word. He said, وَمَن يَعْشُو, whoever ignore Allah's teaching, whoever ignore the facts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do, Allah call him يَعْشُو. Means he cannot see, even he's looking. إِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلْ قُلُوبِ الَّذِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. In fact, the blind person is not the one who cannot see, the one who cannot take the guidance and see the guidance as it should be. So this is the first time of relationship, this type of relationship in the Day of Judgment. When that person stands in front of Allah, what he will say? حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَنَا قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكَ بُعْدَ الْمَشْرِقَيْنِ فَبِئْسَ الْقَرِينِ. SubhanAllah, this is the Quran. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَنَا, when he stands in front of Allah, قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ, I wish if there is as far as the east and the west, the distance between me and you. فَبِئْسَ الْقَرِينِ. That's one thing we have to keep in mind. So in fact, I'm not asking you only to have a good qareen, but I'm asking you to watch for your children as well. If they are doing anything in their life, you want to make sure they are attached to someone, at least if they cannot influence him, he does not take them to the wrong path. Because achievement in life is not only to have good grades in the school, or to have good sports to play, or to have some people to be with, but that's to do something for Allah and only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you look for a friend, you have to look for somebody, and some of the scholars say the best friend is, number one, a wise person, means عاقلاً. Number two, have a good manners. Could be non-Muslim, but with good manners. He will never do something to harm you. Number three, he have a good, the person have a good faith as a Muslim. And you can count, and he is not a sinner. And that's very important for the one you want to have a relationship with. وَلَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمِ الْيَوْمَ إِذْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ فِي الْعَذَابِ مُشْتَرِكُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَأَنْتَ تُسْمِعُ الصُّمَّ الدُّعَاءَ أَفَأَنْتَ تُسْمِعُ الصُّمَّ وَتَهْدِي الْعُمَى وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. So this type of relationship we have to pay attention with. Number two, and it's good to remember that. The Quran call it خَذُول. خَذُول. This word in the Quran. خَذُولَ وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولَ. What does the meaning of خَذُول? And Allah mentioned it in the Quran. A friend who show you that all the time he's loyal to you. A friend, he always want to be with you. A friend, he enjoy the time with you. But if you have any crisis, or if you have any bad need, or you need help, he is the one you will never find. We call him khadula. And you know that. Many, many of the friends, you keep them for a long time. Until one day you are in a bad need for help, or you are in a crisis, and you look for that person, he will never answer the phone. You call him, he's not there for you. You go to him, he's not willing to do anything for you. That you call him khadul. And the best example Allah mentioned in the Quran, الشيطان. وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. The shaitan takes you away from the guidance, from the right thing. But when you stand in front of Allah again, he will walk away. He just have a disclaimer that I never done anything. I just told him and he followed the wrong path. وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ الْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. So you have to remember that meaning when you think about those kind of friends when you have relationships. إِنْ يَنْصُرُكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ وَيَخْذُلْكُمْ خُذْلَان means leave you alone. Stay away from you. ثَمَنْ دَلَّدْ يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدَ. الخذلان ترك العون وقت الحاجة. لا تجعل مع الله إلها آخر فتقعد مذموما. Allah says مخذولا. خذول means no help. If Allah doesn't help you, you never get any help from anybody else. لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إدجاني. He misguided me after I get that right clear message from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. This is number two, and I really think this is a very important topic to think of these words in the Quran. Allah mentioned them. And number three. So number one and number two, خذول. And number three we call it number one قرين. Number two خذول. Number three we call it رفيق. Called friend. Same translation. In fact, when you make wudu, حتى المرفقين مرفق. What we call it مرفق? In Arabic they call this مرفق because attached to you all the time. Always with you. You're marfaq. And a person who's attached to you and close to you all the time, we call him rafiq. So when you need somebody to be with you, you need somebody to help you, not somebody to hold you. You need somebody to guide you, not somebody to misguide you. You need someone to be with you with the good thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this ayah and this ayah, the word rafiq, a very important ayah. It said, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ Whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger. فَأُولَٰئِكَ And those will be مع الذين with أنعم الله عليهم من الأنبياء. The best رفيق is a Nabi. والشهداء, the one who fight for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. والصديقين, not الصادقين, الصديقين. فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من الأنبياء والشهداء والصديقين. وحسن أولئك رفيقا. سبحان الله. When you think الصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا, those who you want them to be your رفيق. So now let's say I am walking somewhere, I don't know what to do. Remember what the Prophet did, how he guided the Muslims during the crisis. Now when there is something happening in Arab country, in the Muslim country, what should they do? Are they my friends, my رفقاء, my أصدقاء, or my إخوان? One of the highest things we call it al-ukhuwa, brotherhood. In fact, when you think about it, all these relationships, to build one type of relationship, we call it al-ukhuwa, a brotherhood. Now if you don't think, when there is a crisis attacking any Muslim in the world, that's not harming you and not touching you as a person, you are not in that level yet as akh or akhu or brother. Now when you look at what's happening in the Middle East in general and in Syria today, and in Egypt, and in Libya, and in Pakistan, and in Kashmir, and in all of the Arab and the Muslim worlds, you will find out if you are not harmed by that, and you are not feeling the pain they are feeling, and the blood being shed all the time, then you are not in that level, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. So Rafiq means a guidance with you, as attached to you as a person, like the best thing to have the Prophet attached to your life. Shuhada attached to your life, like Hamza. And those who are fighting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fighting and struggling for their life, raising their children for their life, by having a good job, or fighting the wrongdoer as well as it's happening, defending their own land, like in Palestine, or in Syria, or other places in the world. We call it al-Rafiq. Number four, Allah called another relationship called Al-Wali. Al-Wali. You know, like when somebody wanna get married, he said, where is the Wali, right? The one who's taking care of the sister, who's speaking on her behalf, we call him Wali. A Wali is a protector, protector. It's not only Rafiq, but the one always there for you when you need him. And the one will never put you down. The one always look what's good for you. The one who's protecting your back all the time. And Allah, what says about that? Allahu waliyyul ladina amanu. Allahu waliyyul ladina amanu. The best wali to have is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through His book, Al-Quran Al-Kareem. And messengers, especially Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the teaching of Islam, Allah waliyyu alladhina amanu. Why is that? Yukhrijuhum. He take them out from al-dhulumat, from the darkness, ila al-nur. And the best wali after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the brothers with a good relationship, Allah waliyyu alladhina amanu. And the sister when she gets married, always she needs a wali, the one who is speaking her behalf, do the best for her and protect her even after marriage. And the one who take care of the Muslims, we call him wali amr al-mu'mineen. Wali amr al-mu'mineen. If he guide him in the right path, not like those who are guiding in the wrong path. Wali. Allah wali alladhina amanu, and there are many verses talking about al-wali. The next, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what he said about al-wali. Then if you choose Allah and His Messenger and the believers, you are in the right path. You are doing the right thing. However, if you choose otherwise, like choosing the Rafiq, Allah says, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. For those who reject faith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let the devils guide them, and the shaytan will be with them, and they will be their wali, and the day of judgment, they will answer for their sins. قَالُوا تَوَلَّوْا أَنْ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَوْلَاكُمْ. And Allah وَلِيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنَ. And many verses. Number five. I'll make it very quick, inshallah. صديق. And this is the only word translated to English. صديق. رفيق. Friend. Now صديق means the most sincere friend. صديقي. صديقي means my brother and the one I talk to all the time. So all of you, my brothers. But I don't talk to all of you at the same time. Or all the time. So but Sadiq, the one you visit, and he visited you. The one who called, he said, you know, I'm leaving, take care of my children, I will be back in 1 week. The one who said, you know what, I cannot pay my bill, can you give me like $300? And he will go pay it without asking you anything. Why? Because he grew up with this relationship. Now a Sadiq, if he is really, really, really true Sadiq, we call him Sadiq. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the non-believers reject what he said about al-Isra'i wal-Mi'raj, and when he came back telling the people, I went from Mecca to Jerusalem to the sky and I came back in the last part of the night, one of the non-believers, he was so excited. He said, now we got him. He's lying. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he went to ask Abu Bakr, what Abu Bakr said? In qalaha faqad sadaq. If he said it, he told the truth. Then he said, how do you believe him? How come he go from Mecca to Jerusalem to the sky and come back? He said, if I believed him bringing the news from Allah, the Quran from Allah, I don't trust him for something like this. Allah can do anything. I believe he is truthful, and if he said it, he saw the truth. Abu Bakr, he said, لَا يَضُرُّ الصَّدِّيقَ شَيْئًا بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ. It's called As-Siddiq. Because he's the one who protect the Prophet, defend the Prophet in his back. And he wasn't. He never done it because the Prophet going to like him. He done it because he believed this is the truth. This is As-Siddiq, Abu Bakr As-Siddiq. As-Siddiqu man sadaqak wa laysa man saddaqak. You don't need a friend who always said, yeah, yeah, it's true. Whenever you tell any story, he said, yes, that's correct. That's not a Sadiq. As-Siddiqu man saddaqak, who said, yes. And if it's wrong, he stabbed you. He doesn't need to do the wrong thing. So number five, we call it As-Siddiq. Number six, and I think that's a very important one. Got Al-Khalil. Al-Khalil. You heard who's Al-Khalilullah. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. Not talking about Ibrahim in detail, but let me tell you one thing. Why Allah chooses Ibrahim among all the messengers to be Khalilullah? Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam born in Iraq. And he traveled from Iraq to Syria. Then from Syria to Egypt for da'wah. And he had a calamity in Egypt. Then he went all the way to Al Jazeera Al Arabiya, to Mecca. And he left his children based on the commands of Allah. He left his son, who is a newborn baby, with his mother, walked away to Palestine. And his wife, when she asked him, why are you leaving us in the dead valley? He said, then she asked him, did Allah order you to do that? He said, yes. Then she said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضَيَّعْنَا. He went to Palestine about 15, 16 years back. He was 84 years old when he had the son for the first time. His father threw him in the fire. And even though after he went to Palestine, came back, Allah ordered him to sacrifice his son, and he accepted. After all of these tests, losing his father, leaving his country, being attacked through his wife. Then he left his son. Then he sacrificed his son. But Allah stopped him. After all of these tests, he passed. Allah called him, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Who can do this except somebody like Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam? Now al-Khalil, al-Akhillahu ba'duhum li-ba'din adu illa al-Muttaqeen. All the akhilla means the friends will be enemy in front of Allah except those who have a relation with taqwa. With taqwa. Subhanallah. May Allah make us among those who make friendship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Khalil. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ This Quran. سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتِي لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. One of the things you would be very, very sad and you wish so many times in front of Allah when you stand and Allah go over all of your deeds, good and bad, and Allah bring all these bad deeds because of your friend, Al-Khalil. Then he said, I wish if I never had him as a friend to start with. يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ when he bites in his hand, عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَا وَيْلَتِي means, you know, woe to me. This is number 6, Al-Khalil. Number 7, Al-Hamim. Al-Hamim. Al-Hamim, subhanAllah, is a type of friendship or a relationship with someone. May or may not that person is close to you. Maybe he's not the one who you go with all the time and come. But when you need any help, that person is Hamim, means will go and go the extra mile to help you out. But he acts like he is very close to you, and he is generous all the time with you. You know, there are some people, when you need them, you call them, and all of them say yes. We call them Hamim. Allah mentioned that in the Quran. فَلَيْسَ لَهُ الْيَوْمَ هَهُنَا حَمِيمٌ. In the day of judgment, when the person loses the battle of good and bad deeds, when his bad deeds more than his good deeds, when he ain't going to his fire, Allah says, فَلَيْسَ لَهُ الْيَوْمَ هَهُنَا حَمِيمٌ. There is no one to protect him but Allah. This is the Hamim, the one you need to protect you all the time. So always take advantage of that by be the one who give support to others, not always take the support from others. فَلَيْسَ لَهُ الْيَوْمَ هَا هُنَا حَمِيمٌ وَلَا طَعَامٌ إِلَّا مِنْ غِسْلِينَ لَا يَأْكُلُهُ إِلَّا الْخَاطِئُونَ. Al-Hamim, which is again, and even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word Al-Hamim, Hamima, from the hellfire. There is one of the punishment about this means something attached like the drink you have. Al-Ma al-Har. الصديق الذي كثر فيه العلاقة مع الإنسان. Number 8, and I will start with number 8 inshallah for the time. We call it Walijah. Walijah. And inshallah we'll speak about Walijah and the last one in the second khutbah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all among those who have good friends and build the friends and seek and do the extra mile to get the good friends for themselves, for their own wives, for their family, and for their own children. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيفوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه إلى يوم أن نلقاه. هذه بعض العلاقات التي رسمها القرآن الكريم والعلاقات التي ذكرها التي يرتبط الإنسان بها مع غيره سواء كان صديقا أو حميما أو وليا أو قرينا أو خليلا أو وليجة. كلها أسماء ورد في القرآن. والله إن هذه لا تستحق أن تكون رسالة ماجستير أو دكتوراه فقط لتمييز العلاقات بطريقة عجيبة في القرآن الكريم. والصفة الأخرى the next and number 8 and 9 إن شاء الله I will speak about two more. One of them is very important. And if I want to speak about one will be number 8. We call it وليجة. وليجة. الله سيدة في القرآن again. وليجة. وليجة. أم حسبتم أن تتركوا لما يعلم الله الذين جاهدوا منكم ولم يتخذوا من دون الله ولا رسوله ولا المؤمنين وليجة والله خبير بما تعملون. وليجة is a kind of friendship who you trust all the time with all the private manners. The private manners you have. You have a problem with your, for example, job, with your family, with your son, with your daughter. You need advice. You go to that person, the one you want to go to, somebody you trust, and you believe he will give you the best suggestions, and he will never talk about you. Walija, billahi, who is better than the imam to be the walija for the Muslims? And I think the best person to be walija is the imam of the masjid, the one who should be involved in solving the problems, the one who should be involved in guiding the community to do the best for them. So now we have to work very hard as a community to find the best imam, the one we call him walija, the one the people trust. Not I'm going to talk to the imam in the morning and the whole neighborhood know about my story in the evening. Not the imam who will give a khutbah by saying, one of the community told me and he have this problem and he give a khutbah about it. That's not walija. Walija is the person who will keep it secret 100% and always check on you and ask you, are you okay? Do you solve the problem? Do you need my help? Allah, my witness, I will never tell anybody because I want you to get out from this problem. We'll have some children, as I mentioned in the last khutbah, they are almost exchanging their deen and their faith. There are some children today, I mean by children 10, 15 years old, maybe 17 years old, they don't pray, they don't fast, they didn't do anything related to Islam. The only thing they do, they go to school, and all their friends are non-Muslims, and they act like non-Muslims. They don't know any chapter from the Quran. They don't know anything about the Prophet. So what do you expect from someone to grow like that when he become 25 years old, or 30 years old, or 40? So now walija means somebody guide you to do all of this in the right way. And the last one, and I will conclude by it, and we call it akhdan, secret relationship, an acceptable relationship. That you build a relationship based on secrets, you didn't get anything from that, but the wrong act. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the believers, وَلَا مُتَّخِذِينَ أَخْدَانٍ. They don't have a secret relationship that something going to keep it between you and somebody else by discussing whatever it is. So now, after we heard about the friendship, what's my job and yours? Number one, to evaluate our friends. And if there is anyone who is not good enough, let's work in him to make it good enough. Number two, we have to be the messengers for da'wah and Islam in this country and in this area. Means let's go up to the expectation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger by what kind of people we have to be with. And number four, it doesn't mean you have to isolate yourself if you didn't have a good friend. It means you have to seek the person who you trust and together grow up to be a good believer. And finally, your children are extremely important and always check on them. Be their friend and make sure they have the right friendship. Because the Prophet ﷺ says, المرء على دين خليله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فإنك علينا قادر والطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اعلي كلمة الحق والدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في سبيلك في كل مكان. اللهم انصرهم في سورية وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في فلسطين وفي العراق وفي اليمن وفي مصر وليبيا وفي باكستان وافغانستان وفوق كل ارض وتحت كل سماء. اللهم انهم جياع فاطعمهم. اللهم انهم بحاجه الى مساعده فاعنهم يا رب العالمين. واقم الصلاه ان الصلاه كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.